A very good evening, everyone. I am Gulapsa, your mentor, and I welcome you all to the session called RBI 247. In today's session, we'll cover important finance-related current affairs, and based on the news that we will discuss, we'll cover important key concepts related to them. But before getting started, let's talk about yesterday's RBI Phase 1 exam that you guys must have given. So, if you have given the exam and if you think कि आपका एग्जाम हो जाएगा, इवन इफ यू हैव अ 1% चांस कि मे बी यू विल बी एबल टू क्लियर द एग्जाम, क्लियर द फेज वन पार्ट ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एग्जाम, देन प्लीज डू नॉट वेस्ट योर टाइम, स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन फ्रॉम टुडे, लेट टुडे बी योर डे वन, है ना? ऐसा नहीं कि रिजल्ट अगर जून 6 तक आएगी तो हम जून 6 तक टाइम को ऐसे ही वेस्ट कर दें ये सोचने में कि पता नहीं मेरा पेपर होगा कि नहीं होगा, whether I'll be able to clear the phase one part or not. Please do not waste your time in thinking such things. Start your preparation for phase two, क्योंकि phase two का exam June 25 को है. Phase two exam is on June 25, right? So there is hardly even a month left. तो अपनी preparation को start करो. Start with a plan. Start with a structured plan so that you will be able to complete the entire syllabus of RBI Grade B phase two during this time period. And in case if you need help, we have also launched a special crash course specifically meant for phase 2 of RBI grade B exam. The crash course will be starting from tomorrow, that is 30th May, Monday se shuru ho jayegi ye course, and the course will be entirely taken by Anuj sir himself. Anuj sir will be covering the entire syllabus of phase 2 in a very comprehensive yet crisp manner. There will be test series as well. He will help you even with the writing of answers. So you can download the timeline for the crash course. You can also see it over here. The timeline will be available on the Telegram group as well as on our website, that is www.anujjindal.in. ठीक है, एंड इन केस ऑफ एनी क्वेरीज यू कैन ऑल्सो कॉल अस एट 9999466225. सो यू कैन कॉल अस एट दिस नंबर इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी और इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट और इन केस यू नीड एनी हेल्प. इवन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट टू अस, यू कैन ऑल्सो मेल अस एट info@anujjindal.in. So please guys, start with your preparation. Don't waste your time ki pehle result aayega, result clear hoga to hum apni preparation ko start karenge. Please don't waste your time. Aaj se hi apni preparation ko start karo. You can take help of this crash course. This will help you leverage your performance in phase 2 of RBI grade B exam. रिजल्ट जब आएगा तब आएगा, अभी से अपनी प्रिपरेशन स्टार्ट करो. एंड फॉर दो स्टूडेंट्स जिनको लगता है कि उनका पेपर अच्छा नहीं गया, प्लीज डोंट बी डिसहार्टेंड. आप अभी से अपनी तैयारी शुरू करो फॉर द नेक्स्ट ईयर. देयर इज ऑलवेज अ चांस, राइट? एंड वी ऑल नो फेलियर्स आर द स्टेपिंग स्टेप्स टुवर्ड्स सक्सेस. सो प्लीज डू नॉट वेस्ट योर टाइम ईदर. आप अपनी प्रिपरेशन अभी से स्टार्ट करो. वन पीस ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन और वन पीस ऑफ एडवाइस फ्रॉम माई साइड विल बी, स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन इन अ कम्प्रेहेंसिव मैनर, दैट इज फेज वन और फेज टू का एक साथ लेकर तैयार करो, है ना? ऐसा नहीं कि पहले फेज वन की तैयारी करेंगे, अगर पेपर क्लियर होता है तो फेज टू की तैयारी करेंगे. अकॉर्डिंग टू मी दिस इज अ रॉन्ग अप्रोच. कम्प्रेहेंसिव वे में तैयारी स्टार्ट करो सो दैट जो आपके कंसेप्ट हैं वो अच्छे से क्लियर हो जाए. फेज टू में देयर कंसेप्ट रिलेटेड टू इकोनॉमिक्स एंड सोशल इश्यूज, राइट? ESI पेपर के कंसेप्ट्स हैं, प्लस देयर कंसेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू फाइनेंस एंड मैनेजमेंट. तो अगर आपका स्टैटिक क्लियर होगा, अगर आपके कंसेप्ट्स क्लियर होंगे, देन दिस कंसेप्ट्स विल हेल्प यू अंडरस्टैंड द न्यूज. जो न्यूज आते हैं जो हम बैंकिंग अवेयरनेस या जनरल अवेयरनेस में कवर करते हैं फेज वन में, दिस विल हेल्प यू बेटर अंडरस्टैंड द न्यूज दैट आर कवर्ड इन स्पॉटलाइट, दैट इज द जनरल अवेयरनेस पार्ट. ठीक है, सो स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन फ्रॉम टूडे. स्टार्ट फॉलोइंग RBI 247, PIB 247, as well as the Spotlight magazine, the daily current affairs which has been taken on our YouTube videos, these all are available for free. तो इन सब रिसोर्सेज का यूटिलाइज करो and start your preparation from today. Don't be disheartened. Abhi se apni preparation ko start karoge, then I'm sure you will achieve great heights in the upcoming RBI exam next year. So for all those who are thinking, who are sure, or who are even 1% sure ki unka paper ho jayega, please start your preparation. Don't waste your time. Apna best do karke jana hai. We need to clear the exam, right? And we all are there to help you in any manner you want, which will help you leverage your performance or clear the exam. So you can call us at this number, or you can even email us at info@anujindal.in. So let's get started. But before that, if you want a one-stop solution to any exam-related updates, live video sessions, monthly magazines, quizzes, as well as topper strategies and past year papers, you can download our app from the Google Play Store, right? So you can download this app. Even if you are an enrolled student, all the courses are available on this. So please make use of the app. This app has been designed specifically for you guys. So please have a look and make use of this app. So let's get started. So aaj hum kya karenge? We'll first discuss the news. Then we'll discuss the concept related to the news. And based on both the news as well as the concept, we will discuss certain questions at the end of the lecture. So what is the news? The news is that RBI has rejected 6 banking license application under the guidelines for on-tap licensing of Universal Bank and Small Finance Banks. So what happened was RBI received 11 applications under the guidelines of on-tap licensing of Universal Banks and Small Finance Banks. Out of this, RBI has examined 6 of them. 6 को RBI ने examine किया है and 5 of them are still under assessment. ठीक है, अब जो इन 6 को RBI ने examine किया है, based on thorough examination as well as assessment, RBI has found that these 6 banks, out of which 4 have applied for the Universal Bank and 2 have applied for the Small Finance Banks, they are not suitable to be granted the license under the on-tap licensing. तो इनको इनको लाइसेंसेस नहीं मिले हैं आरबीआई के द्वारा. नाउ विच आर ऑल दिस बैंक्स? सो द बैंक्स आर यूएई एक्सचेंज एंड फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज लिमिटेड, देन द रेपको बैंक. रेपको बैंक वाज इन न्यूज. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट रेपको बैंक हैज कम अप विद अ स्पेशल डिपॉजिट स्कीम नोन एज रेपको सुभिक्षम. इट इज अ स्पेशल स्कीम, डिपॉजिट स्कीम फॉर द सीनियर एज वेल एज द सुपर सीनियर सिटीजन, राइट? And Chaitanya India FinCredit Private Limited. This is a bank which is related to the Flipkart founder Sachin Bansal, right? Sachin Bansal led Chaitanya India FinCredit Private Limited. Inko bhi licenses grant nahi kiya gaya hai RBI ke dwara. And the fourth one is Shri Pankaj Vaish and others. Theek hai? Talking about the applicants under the Small Finance Bank, these are VSoft Technologies and Calicut City Service Cooperative Bank. Ab jo baki ke 5 bank hain, they are still under assessment and they all have applied under the Small Finance Bank guidelines of RBI. The names of this are mentioned over here. Iski jab decision aayegi tab iske bare mein padhenge. Moving forward, now let us understand what on-tap licensing guidelines are all about of RBI. और ये गाइडलाइंस किन के लिए है? फर्स्ट, इट इज फॉर द यूनिवर्सल बैंक्स इन द प्राइवेट सेक्टर, एज वेल एज द ऑन टैप लाइसेंसिंग इज आल्सो फॉर द स्मॉल फाइनेंस बैंक्स एज वेल. स्मॉल फाइनेंस बैंक्स का जो ऑन टैप लाइसेंसिंग था, इसको हमने प्रीवियस वीडियोस में डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. यू कैन गो देयर, यू कैन विजिट द प्रीवियस वीडियोस एंड यू कैन हैव अ क्लियरर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द आरबीआई गाइडलाइंस फॉर ऑन टैप लाइसेंसिंग ऑफ स्मॉल फाइनेंस बैंक. आज की वीडियो में हम ये डिस्कस करेंगे कि यूनिवर्सल बैंक्स क्या होते हैं, व्हाट इज दिस ऑन टैप फैसिलिटी प्रोवाइडेड बाय आरबीआई, हाउ डिड द ओरिजिन ऑफ ऑन टैप लाइसेंसिंग केम आउट, एंड व्हाट इज द एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया एज वेल एज द इक्विटी कैपिटल रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अ बैंक टू बी अ यूनिवर्सल बैंक. ठीक है, सो स्टार्टिंग विद व्हाट आर यूनिवर्सल बैंक्स. सो दीज आर लाइक फाइनेंशियल सुपरमार्केट. सो दिस इज basically an entity, right? This is basically an entity that undertakes multiple financial activities, Of what are these financial activities? They not only undertake the normal the normal commercial banking activities, but along with that, they also go for investment banking, wealth management, development banking, insurance, merchant banking, housing finance, mutual funds. So all these financial activities are undertaken by one single entity, and this entity is known as a universal bank. ठीक है? And why does these banks undertake all these financial activities? This is because it wants to leverage on the large bank network and provide a wide range of services to its customer under a single bank name. ठीक है? Universal banks का यही criteria रहता है, यही focus रहता है कि वो अपने network को leverage करें, utilize करें, so that they are able to offer a wide range of services to its customers under one single name. I hope universal bank क्या होते हैं आपको clear होगा. What are these? These are financial entities. ये entities होती हैं that undertakes multiple financial activities under one roof. एक roof के अंदर ये सारे financial activities को cover करते हैं. इसको हम कहते हैं universal banks. Now talking about what is this on tap licensing. तो earlier क्या होता था, अगर किसी को bank की license चाहिए होती थी, then RBI used to provide a time frame कि इस time frame के अंदर अगर आप apply करते हो, then RBI will examine and grant the licenses. However, under the on tap facility के अंदर RBI will accept the application for licenses throughout the year. मतलब January 1 से लेके 31st December तक, January 1 से लेके 31st December तक RBI will be accepting the application for the licensing of universal banks as well as small finance bank, and if found suitable, RBI will also grant them the licenses throughout the year. ठीक है? So this is known as on tap licensing. So what is the benefit of on tap licensing? Now the aspirants who wants to apply for the universal bank license, they can apply at any time during the year. However, these are subject to the fulfillment of the set conditions by RBI. ठीक है? पहले RBI एक fixed time frame रखता था जिसके अंदर ही banks को licenses के लिए apply करना पड़ता था. But now they can apply throughout the year, anytime during the year. So this is known as the on tap licensing. और इसके regarding RBI ने guidelines issue किए हैं, and the guidelines related to universal banks has been released in August 2016. Moving forward, now अब इन bank licenses को screen करने के लिए और examine करने के लिए whether they are suitable or not, RBI has also set up a committee. RBI has set up the committee in 2021. The committee will be a 5-member committee. Mind it, जो भी committees होती हैं, anything related to committees are important. Especially who is the chairman? Chairman कौन है? The number of members in the committee, and the terms of reference of the committee. What is the purpose of the committee, right? Terms and reference of the committee. ठीक है? तो अब ये जो committee है, the committee will be known as Standing External Advisory Committee, SEAC. ठीक है? The committee will be known as Standing External Advisory Committee. And it will be a 5-member committee which will be headed by former RBI Deputy Governor Sharmila Gopinath. And what will be the tenure of the committee? The tenure will be of 3 years. That is, agar wo 2021 mein set up kiya gaya tha, then the tenure of the committee will be till 2024. Theek hai? And this committee, what is the purpose of this committee? The committee will evaluate the applications which it has received for the licenses of universal banks as well as for small finance banks. Now talking about the background, why was this on tap guidelines issued by RBI? So RBI came up with a policy discussion paper on banking structure in India in 2013 mein RBI policy discussion paper ke through aaya tha, by recognizing the need of having an explicit policy on banking structure. So there are various committees such as the Narasimhan committee, the Raghuram Rajan committee, right, as well as the Usha Thorat committee. So there are various committees, and these committees have recommended reforms in the banking structure. So recognizing the need for having an explicit policy on banking structure, RBI came out with a policy discussion paper on banking structure in 2013. The policy discussion paper was known as Banking Structure in India, the Way Forward, which was released on August 27, 2013. Now, after going through the discussions and several examination and evaluation, RBI decided to release the guidelines for on-tap licensing of universal banks. ठीक है, तो RBI ने 2013 में ये पेपर रिलीज किया था, एंड बेस्ड ऑन द इवैल्यूएशन एंड फर्दर डिस्कशंस, मतलब बहुत थोरो डिस्कशन किया गया था व्हाट शुड बी द गाइडलाइंस, तो उसको उस बेसिस पे RBI ने गाइडलाइंस इशू किए थे फॉर ऑन टैप लाइसेंसिंग ऑफ यूनिवर्सल बैंक्स, एंड लेटर ऑन द गाइडलाइंस वर आल्सो इशूड फॉर स्मॉल फाइनेंस बैंक्स. ठीक है, मूविंग फॉरवर्ड, अब हु ऑल विल बी द एलिजिबल प्रमोटर्स. As in case of a company, who are promoters? Promoters are the one who set up a company, right? So in case of a bank, these are promoters are the one who sets up the bank. Jo bank form karta hai, the formation of the bank is done by the promoters, right? So what is the eligibility criteria for promoters under the on-tap licensing guidelines? Theek hai? So promoters can be of two types. First, individuals, right? Individuals, and second, entities or groups, right? Now in case of individuals or professionals, two sets of criteria has been prescribed. First, they must be resident Indian, right? They should be a resident of India. What does it mean by to be a resident? Resident means that in the last year for 182 days the person has stayed in India, right? And there are other conditions as well. So it means that the person, the individual or the professional should be a resident in India. And apart from that, it should have a minimum of 10 years of experience. 10 years ka experience hona chahiye in the field of banking and finance, that also at the senior level. Theek hai? This is easy to remember. In case of individual who wants to be a promoter, the eligibility criteria is, first, it has to be a resident. Secondly, it should have a minimum experience of 10 years in the field of banking and finance, that also at a senior level. I hope this is clear to you. Now moving forward to resident entities. Ab entities ke liye kya hai? If an entity wants to set up a bank, a universal bank, then first it needs to be a resident. Theek hai? Unko bhi resident hona padega. They should have a successful track record for at least 10 years. 10 years तक उनका जो business था, उसमें उनका successful track record होना चाहिए. And thirdly, they should have a net asset. They should have net assets worth 50 billion. Now, how much is 50 billion? 50 billion is equal to 5,000 crores. ठीक है? तो उनका जो net assets होने चाहिए, net assets, it should be rupees 5,000 crores, right? अब जो इनका ये net assets है, it should be in the form of financial activities, right? It should be in the form of financial business, right? It can be in the form of financial as well as non-financial. So RBI has put a cap कि जो non-financial business होगा, it should be not more than 40%. That means financial business of this resident entity should be at least that is minimum of 60%. Non-financial business are basically those that are meant for the welfare, right? जिसके लिए profit नहीं चाहिए होता है, welfare के लिए होती है वो चीज, वो non-financial हो गया. तो जो business होगा resident entity का, उसका maximum 40% non-financial हो सकता है, बाकी should be in the form of financial business. Okay, अब ये जो resident entities हैं, now these resident entities can also be other NBFCs as well, right? They can be NBFCs. Now for NBFCs, any existing NBFCs that are resident in India, right? That are controlled by the residents. Any NBFC, any corporation that is controlled by the resident and they also have a successful track record of 10 years, then they will also be eligible in order to convert into a universal bank or to in order to promote a new bank, right? So any existing NBFC having a successful track record of 10 years can either convert into a universal bank, NBFC एक universal bank में convert कर सकता है, या फिर वो एक नए bank को promote कर सकता है. It can be an eligible promoter. I hope this is clear to you. Moving forward, now what is the minimum equity capital requirement for a universal bank? ठीक है. So as per RBI's guidelines, the minimum equity capital for a universal bank should be ₹5 billion. 5 billion कितना होता है? 5 billion is equal to 500 crores. So please keep in mind, जो भी universal bank बनेगा, उनका minimum paid up equity capital 5 billion होगा, that is 500 crores. However, the promoters who will promote the universal bank, उनका जो net asset होगा, वो 50 billion होगा. 50 billion means 5000 crores. ठीक है? ये distinction को याद रखना, जो प्रमोटर होगा, जो बैंक को प्रमोट करेगा, ही शुड हैव अ टोटल एसेट्स वर्थ ₹5000 crore एंड द यूनिवर्सल बैंक दैट इट विल बी प्रमोटिंग, देयर मिनिमम पेड अप इक्विटी कैपिटल शुड बी मिनिमम 5 बिलियन, दैट इज 500 करोर्स. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट आरबीआई इज आल्सो सेट अप दैट द मिनिमम नेट वर्थ of any NBFC that has converted into bank should be ₹5 billion, that is 500 crore at all times. अगर कोई NBFC, existing NBFC, banks में convert होता है, तो उनका जो minimum net worth होना चाहिए, वो 5 billion होना चाहिए. What is net worth? So net worth is equal to the total assets held by the company, right? Held by the bank. माइनस एनी liabilities, राइट. लाइबिलिटीज को अगर हम टोटल एसेट से माइनस कर देते हैं, उसको हम नेटवर्थ बोलते हैं. सो एनी एग्जिस्टिंग NBFC that converts into a universal bank, what are universal bank? That undertakes multiple financial activities, right? तो उनके पास मिनिमम नेटवर्थ 500 करोड़ रुपीज की होनी चाहिए एट एनी पॉइंट इन टाइम थ्रू आउट द ईयर. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. Point 1 and point 2 is clear to you. Moving forward, RBI has also laid down certain guidelines regarding the capital adequacy ratio. Ab capital adequacy ratio kya hota hai? Capital adequacy ratio, also known as capital to risk weighted assets ratio, CRAR. Ye basically ratio hota hai company, ek company ya fir in this case bank's capital, जो बैंक्स की कैपिटल होती है, इट इज अ रेशियो ऑफ बैंक्स कैपिटल टू इट्स रिस्क. व्हाट इज द रिस्क फॉर अ बैंक? इट्स एसेट्स. ठीक है? और ये जो एसेट्स होते हैं, ये रिस्क वेटेड होते हैं. मतलब वेटेज इज प्रोवाइडेड टू द एसेट्स बेस्ड ऑन द रिस्क. सपोज कोई एसेट आपने ऐसे लोगों को दिया है, द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ रीपेमेंट इज वेरी लो, तो उनका रिस्क काफी ज्यादा होगा. सिमिलरली अगर आप टी बिल्स में इन्वेस्ट करते हैं, है ना, अगर आप गवर्नमेंट को बोरो करते हैं, तो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ रीपेमेंट इज मोर, तो वहां पे रिस्क जीरो हो जाएगा. इन केस ऑफ द प्राइवेट पर्सन जिनको आपने लेंड किया है, जिनका क्रेडिट रेटिंग अच्छा नहीं है, उसके केस में रिस्क आपका 100% भी हो सकता है, राइट. सो CRAR बेसिकली एक रेशियो है जो आपके बैंक कैपिटल को, बैंक कैपिटल और आपके रिस्क वेटेड एसेट्स का रेशियो दिखाता है. And this ratio is basically meant to be maintained by the bank. और ये ratio recommend किया गया था Basel III के द्वारा, right? Basel III के द्वारा after the financial crisis, the global financial crisis of 2008. So banks are required to maintain the capital adequacy ratio so that in times of losses, they are able to support their business. So it provides as a cushion to the depositors. एक तरीके का cushion provide करता है banks के depositors को, so that in times of losses there are sufficient capital available so that the stability is maintained in the economy, right? Stability maintained रहेगी और depositors को losses नहीं होंगे. That's why the CRAR is maintained by the bank. As per the Basel III norms, the capital adequacy ratio which was recommended by Basel III norms was 8%. However, In India, RBI has mandated that for the scheduled commercial banks, the ratio will be 9%, the capital adequacy ratio will be 9%, and for the public sector banks, it will be 12%. ठीक है? However, for universal banks, as per the guidelines under on-tap licensing, the capital adequacy ratio for the universal banks will be 13%, a higher percentage. तो जितनी higher percentage होगी capital adequacy ratio का, उतना ही safe and healthy रहेगा वो bank, उतना ही safe किस चीज से रहेगा? Safe that it will not go insolvent. और वो ज्यादा लेवरेज पोजीशन का मिसयूटिलाइज नहीं करेगा. दैट्स व्हाई बैंक्स आर मैंडेटेड टू मेंटेन द कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी रेशियो. एंड जितना ज्यादा रिस्क एक बैंक के साथ जुड़ा होता है, उतना ही कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी बैंक को मेंटेन करना पड़ता है. दैट्स व्हाई इन केस ऑफ यूनिवर्सल बैंक द कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी रेशियो व्हिच अ यूनिवर्सल बैंक इज रिक्वायर्ड टू मेंटेन इज 13%. और ये इनको फॉर अ मिनिमम ऑफ 3 years मेंटेन करना पड़ेगा वंस दे स्टार्ट विद द कमेंसमेंट ऑफ द ऑपरेशंस. अगर बैंक आज स्टार्ट करती है 2022 में, देन टिल 2025 उनका कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी रेशियो मिनिमम 13% होना चाहिए एट ऑल टाइम्स. एंड इफ आरबीआई वांट्स, आरबीआई कैन ऑल्सो इंक्रीज द कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी रेशियो. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट लिस्टिंग ऑन स्टॉक एक्सचेंजेस. सो एनी यूनिवर्सल बैंक which has started its business, which has started its operation of business, has to be listed on the stock exchange within 6 years of the commencement of the business. वो उनको stock exchange पे list करना पड़ेगा. ठीक है? So I hope the capital requirement part is clear to you. In case of universal bank, the minimum paid up equity capital is 500 crores and for the promoters it is 50 billion, that is 5,000 crores. The capital adequacy ratio for the universal bank is 13%. This can be increased if RBI wants so, and they need to be listed on the stock exchange within 6 years. I hope this is clear to you. Moving forward, now what is the corporate structure? अब corporate structure समझने से पहले, let us understand what is this NOFHC. NOFHC stands for Non-Operative Financial Holding Company. अभी आपने देखा होगा आपके फेज वन एग्जाम में फुल फॉर्म्स भी पूछे गए हैं. सो प्लीज डू नॉट अंडर एस्टिमेट कि फुल फॉर्म्स को हम याद नहीं रखेंगे. प्लीज रिमेम्बर द फुल फॉर्म्स एज वेल. ठीक है? तो NOFHC स्टैंड्स फॉर नॉन ऑपरेटिव फाइनेंशियल होल्डिंग कंपनी. दीज आर बेसिकली NBFCs. NOFHC क्या होती है? होल्डिंग, नॉन ऑपरेटिव फाइनेंशियल होल्डिंग कंपनी. होल्डिंग कंपनीज हैं, राइट? And these are NBFCs. What are NBFCs? Non-bank finance companies that do not take deposits. ठीक है? Non-deposit taking NBFCs होती हैं, non-operative financial holding company. और ये वो होती हैं which holds shares in banks as well as other financial service companies. So, for example, एक holding company है. जैसे हमने पढ़ा होगा holding company होती हैं और इनकी subsidiaries होती हैं, right? Similarly, NOFHC एक होल्डिंग कंपनी होगी, राइट? एंड व्हाट आर NOFHC? नॉन ऑपरेटिव फाइनेंशियल होल्डिंग कंपनीज. दीज आर नॉन डिपॉजिट टेकिंग NBFC, नॉन बैंक फाइनेंस कंपनीज होती हैं. नाउ दीज NOFCs आर द वन हु विल होल्ड द शेयर्स इन सेवरल अदर बैंक्स जो इनके अंदर हैं, राइट? दीज आर लाइक एन एंटिटी. ये ग्रुप एंटिटी है, राइट? दीज आर एन एंटिटी व्हिच विल होल्ड शेयर्स इन द बैंक्स एज वेल एज अदर फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज कंपनी. सपोज इसके अंदर कोई म्यूचुअल फंड है, कोई इंश्योरेंस कंपनी है, तो इन सब कंपनीज में, इन सब सब्सिडरीज में ये जो NOFHC है, इसने शेयर्स होल्ड किए हुए हैं. ठीक है? एंड दीज फाइनेंशियल एंटिटीज, द फाइनेंशियल कंपनीज एज वेल एज द बैंक्स मस्ट बी रेगुलेटेड बाय RBI, राइट? इन केस ऑफ बैंक्स मस्ट बी रेगुलेटेड बाय RBI और एनी अदर फाइनेंशियल रेगुलेटर based on the permissible regulatory prescriptions, right? So these banks as well as the financial services companies should be regulated. In short, ye regulated hone chahiye either by RBI or any other financial regulator. So what is a corporate structure? Now, ab humne promoters ke bare mein padha tha ki agar individual, the promoters can be individual or entities, right? Group entities ho sakti hain. अगर प्रमोटर इंडिविजुअल है या फिर प्रोफेशनल है जिनका कोई ग्रुप एंटिटी नहीं है, जिनके पास ग्रुप एंटिटी नहीं है, देन फॉर सच प्रमोटर्स NOFHC इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, इज नॉट मैंडेटरी। अगर इंडिविजुअल प्रमोटर के पास NOFHC है, होल्डिंग कंपनी है, तो उसके थ्रू वो इन्वेस्ट कर सकता है, इसके थ्रू वो अपनी शेयर होल्डिंग रख सकता है जो यूनिवर्सल बैंक बनाई जाएगी। बट इन केस ग्रुप एंटिटी नहीं है देन NOFHC इज नॉट मैंडेटरी इन केस ऑफ इंडिविजुअल प्रमोटर्स। आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू। नाउ इन केस ऑफ एंटिटीज दैट ऑल्सो ग्रुप एंटिटीज, अगर इनके पास ग्रुप एंटिटीज हैं, राइट, अगर इनके पास ग्रुप एंटिटीज हैं, देन दे आर अलाउड टू सेट अप अ यूनिवर्सल बैंक ओनली थ्रू इट्स होली ओन्ड NOFHC। इनके लिए NOFHC होना जरूरी है, ओनली थ्रू दिस होल्डिंग कंपनी दे कैन सेट अप अ यूनिवर्सल बैंक। समझ में आ गया? इंडिविजुअल के केस में अगर ये इनके पास कोई ग्रुप एंटिटी नहीं है, देन हैविंग अ होल्डिंग कंपनी, अ नॉन ऑपरेटिव financial holding company is not mandatory. However, in case of entities having group entity, wo universal bank tabhi set up kar sakta hai agar only through the NOFHC, that is non-operative financial holding company. I hope this is clear to you. Promoter se relate karke padhna, aapko samajh aa jayega. It is easy to remember as well. Theek hai, individual ke case mein NOFHC is not mandatory. However, in case of entities having group entities, they are permitted to set up a universal bank only through a wholly owned non-operative financial holding company. Moving forward, shareholding kya rahegi? अब जो प्रोमोटर है, प्रोमोटर कहा जा रहा है इंडिविजुअल के केस में जहां पे NOFHC इज नॉट मैंडेटरी, एंड अगर ग्रुप एंटिटी है वहां पे NOFHC इज मैंडेटरी, राइट, तो इनका जो होल्डिंग होगी, देयर शेयर होल्डिंग इन द न्यूली सेटअप यूनिवर्सल बैंक शुड बी मिनिमम ऑफ 40% ऑफ इट्स पेड अप वोटिंग इक्विटी कैपिटल। अब रिमाइंड करो खुद को कि वोटिंग कैपिटल कितना था यूनिवर्सल बैंक्स के लिए, इट वाज 500 करोड़, ठीक है। तो इसका 40% मिनिमम NOFHC को होल्ड करना पड़ेगा, दे शुड होल्ड द शेयर्स एटलीस्ट 40% फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 5 years, फॉर अ लॉक्ड इन पीरियड, और ये लॉक कर दिया जाएगा 5 years के लिए, राइट, फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ द कमेंसमेंट ऑफ बिजनेस। सो लेट अस टेक एन एग्जाम्पल, अगर सपोज जनवरी 1, 2020 को एक यूनिवर्सल बैंक सेटअप किया जाता है, राइट, यूनिवर्सल बैंक सेटअप किया जाता है, देन विद इन फाइव इयर्स ऑफ कमेंसमेंट ऑफ बिजनेस प्रोमोटर की जो शेयर होल्डिंग होगी वो मिनिमम 40% होगा, ठीक है, मिनिमम 40% होगा, और ये लॉक कर दिया जाएगा। That means the promoter cannot withdraw the 40% holding from this universal bank. ठीक है, तो ये आ जाएगा आपका 2025. Now with time, अब ये जो share holding है promoters की, इसको अब reduce करना होगा. How कैसे होगा ये? Now it says the shareholding should be brought down to 30%. अब 40% से shareholding को हम 30% तक लेके आएंगे, मैक्सिमम 30 तक लेके आएंगे, कितने साल में, विद इन अ पीरियड ऑफ 10 years, राइट, फ्रॉम द स्टार्ट ऑफ द बिजनेस, 2020 में स्टार्ट हुआ था, तो यहां से 10 years कितना हो जाएगा, 10 years विल बी 2030, राइट, 5 years तक लॉक इन पीरियड रहेगा, उसके 5 years बाद इनको 30% तक रिड्यूस करना पड़ेगा अपनी शेयर होल्डिंग, एंड the shareholding will have to be reduced further to 15%. अब इसको हमें 15% तक reduce करना है, right? By within a period of 15 years from the date of commencement of the business. Business commence किया गया था 2020 को, 2020 से 15 years, 5 years 2025, 10 years 2030. अब हमें देखना है 15 years, 15 years कितना हो जाएगा 2035, राइट, सो 2035 तक यूनिवर्सल बैंक के जो प्रमोटर्स होंगे, दैट इज द नॉन ऑपरेटिव फाइनेंशियल होल्डिंग कंपनी एज वेल एज द इंडिविजुअल प्रमोटर्स, उनको अपनी शेयर होल्डिंग को रिड्यूस करना पड़ेगा टू 15%, राइट? 15% तक रिड्यूस करना पड़ेगा. जस्ट अ सेकेंड. सो आई होप दिस वॉज क्लियर टू यू. ये आपको क्लियर होगा. जस्ट अ सेकेंड. राइट, मूविंग फॉरवर्ड. दिस गाइडलाइंस ऑन स्मॉल फाइनेंस बैंक्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड, राइट? ये गाइडलाइंस तो हमने पहले पढ़ चुके हैं इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियोस. जस्ट फॉर कंपैरिजन, यूनिवर्सल बैंक के केस में मिनिमम पेड अप इक्विटी कैपिटल कितना था? 500 crores. इन केस ऑफ स्मॉल फाइनेंस बैंक्स इट इज 200 crores, राइट? नाउ एनी प्राइमरी अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक who wants to transit into a small finance banks, initial requirement 100 crores hogi. However, within 5 years, unko 200 crores tak aana padega. Secondly, any payment bank who has completed 5 years of its operation can convert into a small finance banks, right? Talking about the eligible promoters, in case of universal banks, individual ke liye tha 10 years of experience, right, in banking and finance at senior level. In case of small finance banks, same rules applies. However, in case of entities, yahan pe bhi 10 years ka successful track performance hona chahiye tha, right? And 5,000 crore rupees of assets should be there with the entity. In case of small finance banks, ye jo successful track performance hona chahiye, track record, it should be only for 5 years. Theek hai? Moving forward. So this was all for the news. Now moving forward to the questions. So the first question says, which of the following committee has been formed by RBI to evaluate the licensing application for universal banks and small finance banks? Committee, we have already discussed, the name of the committee was Standing External Advisory Committee. So option A is the correct answer. Ab inke bare mein bhi thoda bahut jaan lete hain, because we have given it in the options. So inke bare mein dekh lete hain. Now, in order to curb black money in the economy, Justice M.B. Shah Committee was formed. Now, this question was asked in the IBPS mains of 2016, right? 2016 ke IBPS PO mains mein ye question pucha gaya tha, that which of the following committee was meant to curb black money in the economy. So the right answer was Justice M.B. Shah Committee. So I've taken this point here just in case to show you that questions on committees have been asked in banking exams, right? So RBI is also one of a kind of banking exams. So please keep in mind the name of the committee and the purpose for which the committee was formed. Moving forward, AC Shah Committee. The committee was formed in order to provide reforms related to non-bank finance companies. Similarly, K. Madhav Das Committee was formed to talk about the urban cooperative banks, and R.H. Khan Committee was made for the purpose of harmonization of role of financial institutions in banks. Also, it is after the recommendations of R.H. Khan Committee that the conceptualization of universal banking as a different concept was made in India, right? So universal banking was first talked about after the recommendations of the R.H. Khan Committee. After this committee only, the conceptualization of universal banking was done. So R.H. Khan Committee is an important committee. I hope you will keep the, you will remember the name as well as the purpose of the committee. Moving forward to the next question. The question says, RBI's Standing External Advisory Committee is headed by. Abhi humne isko padha tha. The correct answer is B. Shyamala Gopinath. Ex-RBI Deputy Governor Shyamala Gopinath will be heading the committee which is meant to screen the bank licenses for universal banks and small finance banks, and the tenure will be of 3 years. I hope you will remember this. Moving forward to the next question. Based on whatever we have studied, the question says, according to the RBI guidelines for on-tap licensing of universal banks in the private sector, what is the minimum paid-up voting equity capital required for a bank to be a universal bank? They're asking about the paid up voting equity capital for a bank to be a universal bank. So the correct answer to this question is also obvious, as we have already discussed. The correct answer is A, rupees 500 crores, or we can say 5 billion, right? Now moving forward to the next question. But before that, let us revise. The minimum paid up equity capital for a bank to be a universal bank is 5 billion 500 crore. However, for the promoter to start up with a universal bank, their net assets should be 50 billion, which is equal to 5000 crore rupees. Theek hai? And the capital adequacy ratio is 13%. For small finance banks, it is 15%. Ye yaad rakhna. And they need to be listed on the stock exchange within 6 years. Moving forward to the last question for today. The question says, with regard to the RBI guidelines for on-tap licensing of universal banks, which of the following statement or the statements is or are incorrect? Now we need to find out the incorrect statements. The statements are, in order to be an eligible promoter of universal banks, resident entities or groups in the private sector should have a successful track record of at least 10 years and a total assets worth 500 billion. Ab yahan pe confused mat ho na. 10 years, theek hai. This is wrong. Ye 50 billion hai. Abhi I have discussed, it is 50 billion, which is equal to 5000 crore rupees. Theek hai? Ye statement galat ho gaya. Second statement says, under the guidelines, the bank would be required to maintain a minimum capital adequacy ratio of 15% of its risk-weighted assets for a minimum period of 3 years. Here we are talking about the on-tap licensing of universal banks. So 15% fir ye galat ho jayega, because the capital adequacy ratio is 13%. So this is also wrong. Moving forward to the third question, third statement. The statement says, the shareholding of the promoter should be brought down from 40% to 15% within a period of 15 years from the date of commencement of the business of the bank. This is absolutely correct. We need to find out the incorrect statements, which are 1 and 2. So the correct answer is D, 1 and 2. Statement 1 and 2. We have already discussed total assets should be 50 billion. Their shareholding, and out of which non-financial business should not be more than 40%. And existing NBFCs can also be eligible to be a promoter, as well as they can also be converted into a universal bank. And we have also discussed this, that the shareholding of the promoter should be brought down to 30% within 10 years and 15% within a period of 15 years from the date of commencement of business of the bank. I hope today's session was clear to all of you. In case if you need a free PDF of today's session, you can get it. You can download it from our Telegram channel by joining our Telegram channel and group. All free PDFs are uploaded to this channel. Right? Anujindal.in. So this was all for today. I hope you like the session. Start with your phase 2 preparation. We are all here to help you sail through the exam. Give your best. Do not waste any time. Just start your preparation. Let today be your first day, your day 1 for phase 2, and give your best. Goodbye and take care.